All right, first start video. Video for a buddy of mine, but I'm gonna go ahead and turn it into a heat cycle video. A lot of people ask me how to do heat cycles. I really can't answer that question. There's too many different ways, but this is my way. This is very first start on a fresh Redline top end. I'm just gonna show you guys how I do it. The first cycle, just get it to run. Try not to do too much tuning on it. Don't let it idle too much. Get it running decent like this. This motor has been running a total of 4 minutes and 50 seconds now. Just clear it out every now and then. Don't give it a hard rev. Just clear it out some. 30 mains in it with stock pilots. It's gonna need 27.5s. I knew that, but I didn't have any. The air screws are all the way shut. That's what you saw me doing at the beginning. That's why it sounded so funky. I had to take and turn the air screws all the way shut. This has a Redline slate port. So I'll go ahead and get heat cycles on it, and I'll order in some 27.5s, and we should be good to go. For about 5-7 minutes, something like that, just until it's good and warm. I mean, I can still put my hand on it and hold it. So let's see. About 7 seconds and I gotta let go. I'm getting ready to shut it down in about another minute and a half. But this engine here, I didn't do a video on it. It's got a hot rod crank in it. Redline slate port with a 6450 wide coat pistons in it. This is a customer's bike. Sounds pretty good. I'm going for surgery in 3 days, so I'm trying to get this customer out of the way so he don't have to wait on me, because I'm going to be down for a couple of weeks. And notice I keep my fan on the radiator to keep it cool. The top of the radiator is pretty hot, as long as I can hold it. But this part's nice and cool. Got plenty of air going through it. If you need to, but if you got a good machinist, don't be scared to rev on it a little bit. You're not gonna hurt it. That's 9 minutes. That's one heat cycle for me. Second time, like I said, I'll let it cool all the way down, and then I'll come out and fire it up, and you know, make any adjustments if I need to. Check the coolant level, be sure it's still good, be sure we're not losing anything. But full to the top still, and it's just got straight water in it. I don't run any coolant until I'm sure that there wasn't going to be any leaks or anything like that. So after all three successful heat cycles, I'll drain it, flush it, put engine ice in it or coolant, you know. But anyway, that's a heat cycle. I'll show the other two. Y'all have a good day. God bless. And stop. Well, guys, my phone won't quit recording.